haven't shaved in a while. It's been 2 weeks because my razor broke. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. And at the end of the video, if you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that like button as well, as it does really help me out a lot. So, as you can tell by the title of this video is about inspirations. People who inspired me, hence the word inspiration. So, this topic is going to be part one of two, might do three, I don't know. It's just going to be a part one, because I've got so many different inspirations for different matters, but this one is based solely around YouTube and content creators. Back in 2009, 2010, there was a YouTuber I used to watch a lot, a very popular British YouTuber called Charlie Is So Cool Like. Now, Charlie kind of kicked off, well, I wouldn't say he kicked off the vlogging scene, but he was the person who I discovered vlogging through. And he would do different challenges, he would just talk to the camera, he'd educate people, he'd do comedy sketches, and that was it. That was Charlie Is So Cool Like. And he was brilliant. He had loads of opportunities. He got to do with the BBC, got to go on set for Doctor Who. And yeah, he was a massive inspiration for me growing up. Around the time of being 12, 13, 14, I was watching Charlie Is So Cool Like. He was the person who I looked at first and thinking, I want to do that. I really, really, really want to do that. I want to be able to sit in front of a camera, talk to the camera, and get a big audience, I guess. So Charlie Is So Cool Like doesn't really post as regular as he used to do. He was, however, one of the first, I think he was the first British YouTuber to hit 1 million subscribers, which is a milestone that he'll forever have. But now he just kind of got on with his own life. He'd done that. He started as a teenager when he'd just finished his GCSEs and went on to his mid-20s to do it. And now he just does it for educational purposes, which is really cool. He started his Fun Science series where he talks about random science facts. Yeah, Charlie Is So Cool Like is kind of the person who inspired me to kind of do YouTube. My second inspiration is my inspiration for comedy. The comedic aspect I try to put into my videos is very bland, very packed with memes, and just stupid, really. And that all comes from one of my favourite YouTubers for a very long time, and that is Pyrocynical. I discovered Pyrocynical while watching this other YouTuber react to those MLG montage parodies. And I found Pyrocynical through that, and I thought he was hilarious, some of the stuff that he used to do. And that was my kind of humour back then. I think that was kind of everyone's humour. That kind of started the whole dank memes and stuff like that. Yeah. I started watching his videos from that, and then eventually Pyrocynical branched off into the whole commentary videos, where he would play some video game in the background and he would just be talking about either news or stuff that's been going on with YouTube, and he just basically puts his own thoughts into it. He was inspired from another YouTuber called Leafy Is Here, who is just kind of not here anymore, he's just disappeared. I wonder what happened. But yeah, so Pyrocynical, I tried to, I don't want to say copy, but heavily inspired his comedy from that I tried to put into my videos. Now, one of my main inspirations is the person who kind of gave me that last kick to just kind of do this. I mean, apart from my girlfriend, who basically told me, you got to do this because you love it. But the person who I've been watching so much recently, for the past year, maybe 2 years, and that is Casey Neistat. I'm pretty sure you can tell from my videos, especially my day out vlogs, I have a very, very, very heavily influenced style of video with the same as his. The guy is inspirational, just in general, not just with video making, but just as a whole. He's created businesses from the ground up. He had his own TV series on HBO with his brother. He can just do whatever he wants because he can. He's Casey Neistat. He's flown on airplanes that are costing $50,000 or whatever stupid amount. The guy's camera work and the whole story plot for videos is brilliant. The way he portrays his videos, the way he edits them, just everything about it is just perfect, and it's just something that I've wanted to do. And now doing YouTube and doing all the stuff, like trying to do some of the stuff that he does, you don't realize how much effort goes into his videos. And he does that on a daily basis. Not as much as when he did his daily vlogs, but he used to do that on a daily basis. The guy was waking up at 4 a.m. He would be going to bed at 2 a.m. or something like that. And he was just constant working and grinding to get where he is now. Now he's on over 10 million subscribers. He's got 368, which is his new company that he started, once again, from the ground up. The guy is a businessman. He knows what he's doing, and he's an inspiration for that. His videos are incredible, and the fact he can get them out at such a fast rate is just mind-blowing, and the stuff he gets to do is insane. And his quote, "Do what you can't," was kind of my final push to do vlogging. And I was terrified. I mean, if you remember my first ever vlog, I was just like this and just scared and practically whispering to the camera. But now it's just, I've gotten used to it. Watching his videos is making me go further to do more stuff. I mean, I've got so many videos planned. I've got a list of them on my phone. I mean, I've got about 8 videos planned in the works. I'm keeping it blurry because I don't want to give anything away. I'm so excited to do all this now. I'm happy that I'm so confident in front of the camera because of all these people. And these YouTubers inspired me to do all this stuff, and it's making me think of my own sort of style. And now I can adapt and change, and I'm trying different things with my vlogs. Having this opportunity to do this sort of stuff is amazing. And I'm so happy that I'm actually doing it, because I didn't think I'd be doing this. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I have 3 main YouTubers. I do want to give honorable mentions to another few of my favorite YouTubers, such as JonTron. The production in his videos is just awesome. I watched his original videos and everything like that. It was just, I used to want to do that. I mean, I started off trying to do gaming videos with Grand Theft Auto. Now, I know that isn't the sort of thing that JonTron does, but his comedy and everything, I love that style. So JonTron is an honorable mention. There's a YouTuber called NerdCubed who kind of inspired me to do gaming videos, but I never really fully went down that route. I mean, there is somewhere on YouTube my early gaming videos, including Minecraft and Grand Theft Auto, but I'll save them for a future video. Maybe a 1,000 subscriber special. If I ever reach that, that is. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm keeping this one short and sweet and quick. I'm recording this the day before the upload time. I'm gonna edit this right now, and hopefully it'll be ready for Wednesday. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this one. Once again, if you did enjoy it, make sure you hit a like down below. And if you aren't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well. I hope to see you guys in the next video. It's not going to be the part 2, it's probably going to be something else. Part 2 will be coming in the future, where I talk about my inspirations within family and friends. So thank you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.